flavor we've been kicking is what you've been missing. Although it's free, we gon' make you pay attention. And there's one more thing that we forgot to mention. Go ahead and like, share, subscribe, and then listen. Bootleg Cable Podcast, flavor in your ear. Bootleg Cable Podcast.
All right, we back for another week. This is episode 30. I am P-Double.
Yeah, yeah, it's your man, Skilla Cal.
This is Bootleg Cable Podcast. What
yeah,
it is.
Yeah, man, it's bootleg, but ain't nothing fake about it, man. We here. Good
yes,
with
sir.
You, Dub.
Yes, sir. I'm here chilling, man, chilling. Yesterday.
Yeah.
I know I kind of hinted at it a little bit earlier. Yesterday, your boy got pulled over by the popo, dude.
Yeah, man, what she was doing, man?
All right, so hopefully I can explain this correctly.
Sound like you're guilty.
No.
Sounds like you're guilty to me.
Hopefully I explain it for our listeners that don't watch us on the YouTube.
Uh-huh.
Matter of fact, man, when y'all check us out, man, check us out on the YouTube. If you got a chance to, you know, watch us at home or whatever, check us out on the YouTube. Or if you want to go, check us out on SoundCloud. You know what I'm saying? And then also, what is it? Like, subscribe, whatever it
is. Yeah, if you're listening right now, go ahead, click the subscribe button below.
Yeah.
Right there on SoundCloud, right there on YouTube. It's right there. Just click that button, man. And we won't disappoint.
And also follow your boys on social media.
Yeah, right? IG,
Twitter.
Yeah.
Like our Facebook page. We really appreciate it, man.
Yeah, man. You're going to see the IG name on the screen right now. You're going to see the Twitter name. So,
yeah.
You know what I mean? Holla at us.
Yeah.
All
right,
so
I'm driving home from work yesterday, right?
Uh-huh.
And it's three lanes. For those of us who live in Broward County, we know what it is. Turnpike, going north. Three lanes. I'm right around the area of Coconut Creek. Let's call the far left lane, middle lane, right lane, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you're going north, and then you also have that little those little rest stops on the left-hand side, mm-hmm. right? So I'm driving.
You're talking about the pike?
I'm on the pike, yeah.
All right, cool.
So, you know, they have that merge lane where you're coming from the rest stop.
Right, right.
Traffic is blocked up like crazy,
mm-hmm.
right? It's pretty much at a standstill. So mm-hmm. maybe three or four cars in front of me, police officer.
Yeah.
So I'm like, damn, man, you know how I don't know about you in traffic, but I be kind of antsy. Like, nigga, I just want to go home. Like, I don't want to be stuck in this shit.
Uh-huh, true.
So I try to go around and, you know, nine times out of ten, it really don't make a big difference in your commute. But you try to,
wherever you can squeeze in, squeeze
exactly,
in.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah, yeah. So I did that. Like I said, it's the merge lane. Then you have the left lane, middle lane, and right lane. I was in the left lane.
Yeah.
So cop, four cars in front of me. I said, I saw a little daylight on the merge lane or whatever. So I said, all right,
mm-hmm.
swerve over into the merge lane. Let me get in front of traffic a little bit.
Uh-huh.
As I do that, I start driving forward. The cop comes out of his lane. He's mm-hmm. also in the left lane,
mm-hmm.
into the merge lane.
Yeah.
So I stop. I wasn't going too fast or anything like that. So I stop. And then he wind down his window. He's talking on the phone.
Mm-hmm.
And he holds his hand out the window like this, palm up.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm looking at him, mm-hmm. and I'm like, yo, is you coming or going? And I'm thinking he asking me like, yo, is you coming or going?
Uh-huh.
So I'm like, all right. So I kind of swerve around him and then continue on my way.
Yeah.
Woo! Lights flash.
Mm.
I'm like, what the hell?
Yeah.
So I pull over to the side. He jump out the car. You know why I pulled you over? I was like, nah, I don't know why you pulled me over. What's going on?
Uh-huh.
He was like, you know what you just did was illegal, right? I was like, what did I do?
Yeah.
He was like, you used the merge lane as a changing lane, as a passing lane.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, well, traffic is technically stopped.
Yeah.
So, well, I was like, what are you talking about?
It's a lane.
Exactly. I was like, I said it wasn't no double line. It wasn't no single solid line or whatever, whatever. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
What you did was illegal and you can't do that, whatever, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just like, dude, I said, I'm just trying to go home, trying to go wherever I'm going.
Yeah.
Like what's the problem?
Mm-hmm.
I saw you were in this lane and he describing to me exactly what I did or whatever. I said, so I pulled up and you basically cut me off, right?
Yeah.
So when you put your hand out the window, I'm thinking you're asking me, what am I doing?
This is what you're asking, telling him.
Yeah, I told him the exact same way.
Yeah.
I'm thinking you asking me, what am I doing? I said, you put your hand out, palm up like this.
Right.
to me, that meant like, yo, you coming or going? Like, what is you doing?
Yeah. Let's keep the shit
and moving. And I waited for you, uh-huh. and you stood there, or you stopped there, and you didn't do nothing. So I went around you. Uh-huh. Oh, no, you can't do that. This, that. You don't know the rules to driving on the roads and whatever, whatever. And he talking all kind of nonsense.
Okay.
And I'm like, dude, what you did was illegal. I was like, okay, so what you did was illegal then too.
Yeah.
I said, if I can't switch into the merge lane to go where I'm going, mm. I said, so you purposely cut me off. He was like, yeah, I purposely cut you off. I was like, so is that not illegal?
Yeah.
I'm a police officer. I can do whatever I need to do to stop somebody from committing a crime or whatever or whatever. I was like, dude, I was like, a crime?
Yeah.
I was like, a crime, really?
Yeah.
He was like, the drivers like you is the reason why the highways are backed up like this and this and that, whatever.
I was like, he gave you a ticket for all this shit?
No, he ain't give me no ticket.
Because, I mean, that's what I'm trying to wonder. What the fuck can he write on his ticket?
So he hopped out. Like I said, he talking, and I'm going at it with him, right? Yeah. I don't know why.
But he
I
was, don't have a case though. So
he don't have
much
a case. So basically, when I made my case against his case, and he was just like, "Well, I could start writing tickets if you want me to do that."
Oh, first of all, was he Highway Patrol or not?
He wasn't, and I was gonna get there.
Oh, okay. So
he was like, "Should I start writing tickets or whatever?"
Oh,
whatever.
I hate motherfuckers
man. And I'm just like, dude. I was like, "Yo, man." Yeah. I said, "Do what you got to do." Let me see your driver's license registration. So,
that's when he want to check if you have anything. That way, he can fuck with you on that.
Exactly. So yeah. I give him my driver's license. I give him my insurance. I give him my registration.
Yeah.
And then he smelled that new car smell coming out the car. Uh-huh. He was like, "Is this a new car?" I was like, "Yeah, it's fairly new." Uh-huh. Like, yeah. What does that have to do with anything? Like, why are you asking me if I have a new car or not?
Yeah.
So he, you know, and, oh, you know, I drive this way every day, blah, 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 this, that, and the third.
Yeah.
So he couldn't give me a ticket. I'm going to tell you why he couldn't give me a ticket.
Yeah.
He was a plantation police officer.
Right.
We in Coconut Creek.
Uh-huh.
You out your jurisdiction, buddy.
Correct, yes.
So you just abusing your power.
Uh-huh.
All you could do is hold me there.
Yeah, and you're a civilian right now, my nigga.
Exactly. Like, you know what I'm saying? You're not even on duty.
So he's driving home. He's like, "Hey, I'm respecting the law and I'm staying in this lane." And all these assholes just keep skipping over into that lane
there
who have this wonderful idea. Why nobody else does it, I don't understand.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And second of all, like, yo, I don't remember taking my driver's license test and they tell me don't get into that fucking lane.
Exactly.
Like, when does it say that?
Like, you just use this lane as a passing lane.
When does
whatever,
it say
whatever.
You can't use this merging lane as a passing lane?
Dude,
like,
I was thinking about it, y'all. Yeah. I should have recorded it.
As long as it ain't a solid line. You didn't cross a solid line, right?
It wasn't a solid line. It was a broken line.
It's broken lines. So I could use it what the fuck I want to do with it.
I'm looking like, dude, you just abusing your power.
You know, no, he's not abusing his power. He's just so much of a fucking prick. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's driving the quote unquote correct lane all the time, and he's like tired of motherfuckers jumping in that lane and getting around. Like, this is not fair.
Exactly.
And he's gonna let you know why it's not fair.
Exactly.
And he thought he was gonna get somebody that fucking could agree with him. Like, get the fuck out of here, yo.
Yeah, man.
Sit your stupid ass down somewhere with that bullshit. You have nothing but a mall cop at this point. You
exactly, man. Like,
man.
Dude, you just go home.
Yeah,
like,
I got pulled over by a cop. You know what I'm saying? I'm speeding and shit. Like, I hate when I see motherfuckers do that. Like, they be driving on the 95 or something like that, and you know everybody's boogieing. But as soon as they see a cop, everybody start going to pace of what the cop is going.
Yeah.
I'm like, yo, hold up, what county we in? Oh, this ain't his jurisdiction. I'm out.
Yeah,
I'm out.
Hell
like,
yeah,
I'm not staying behind this dumbass. Like, if he want to drive slow, let him drive slow. I'm out.
If it's me, you know, yeah. Oh, I've been doing this for 14 years or whatever. This, yeah. That, they're like, dude, you off right now. You headed opposite the direction of your jurisdiction.
Yeah,
you off.
You off. You going home. Take like, your ass home.
Like I said, it wasn't like I was going fast. It wasn't like I just murked out into the lane. And like, dude, traffic is backed up. I'm trying to. Wherever I see daylight, that's where I'm going.
Right.
And this upset you. For you to pull over, talk all that shit and then not give me a ticket because you can't give me a fucking ticket.
Right. You know what I'm saying? But he just felt like he had to say something about it. I bet you if a civilian could pull you over at that point, they probably would.
Exactly.
So yeah, some white dude behind you. Hey, buddy, you know that's not fair. You know, everybody else got to drive in this lane, but you use the merging lane to fucking pass everybody. Do you think that's fair? Shut the fuck up and get out of my face.
For real, man.
Yeah, white people be too nosy, man. That's all it is. I'm sorry, y'all. I love white people, but y'all be nosy as fuck, yo. That's what the fuck that is, yo. Nosy ass.
What's good with you, though, man?
Man, nothing, man. My shit chilling, man. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Just getting through my week, you know? I haven't had much time to do anything, man. Okay. I haven't even done any research on this podcast, man, so I'm just here to do a podcast. So, you know, what up to the listeners, man?
It kind of got to be like that sometimes,
yeah,
man.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah, yeah. We gonna keep it fun for y'all, though.
So, on Easter now, I went to a little house party or whatever.
Yeah,
having a good time at the house party and whatnot,
right?
And I hit you up on Easter.
Yeah, you did.
And then what do we see? What I hit you up about on Easter?
Yo, so you sent me a video, man. I'm like, yo, first of all, like I said, I'm a squeamish ass dude. I don't like to look at certain things. I don't like to see certain things. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I take the description as on face value and say, okay, this is what this is.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna look at this. But in this particular point, what you sent me, I was like, yo, this can't be true, man. I'm going to look at this. I'm going to see what this is.
Yeah.
So come to find out, we're watching a man, you know, that's pretty upset, getting out of a car and walking to an elderly man,
mm-hmm,
and shooting him live on Facebook Live.
Well, we found out later that it wasn't actually live on Facebook. Like, he shot him and then uploaded the video of him shooting him.
Okay.
So that was,
yeah, know. Well, but, however, yeah, yeah, this is this
same,
is my
same
position.
Difference.
Yeah, this is what the description says. So I'm looking at this shit, and dude, like, you know, walk up on this elderly man. Elderly man was like, yo, wait, what the fuck is going on? Like, not saying what the fuck is going on, but wait, what's going on?
Yeah.
And my man said, yo, because of such and such female, this is why this has happened to you. Put a gun to the man's head.
And not even just that. Yeah. Tried to make him say her name.
Make her say, yeah. And dude said his name, like, who the fuck is she? Who the fuck is her?
I have no clue who you talking about.
Yeah,
here.
Yeah, man. That, yeah. Yeah, man. So, yeah, I seen that. I'm like, holy shit, what the fuck did I just watch?
Mm-hmm.
So, immediately, I'm starting to look around, you know, scouring the internet, trying to find out what's going on. I'm looking at the news and everything like that, seeing if they're reporting it. I'm not seeing anything on the news. I'm not really seeing much on the internet,
mm-hmm,
until later on that evening when stuff starts circulating a little bit. That's when the shit start coming up. I'm like, yo, holy shit, this shit is real. This shit just happened.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah.
So, this crazy dude, what's his name? Steve Stevens.
Yeah, Stevie Steve, I call him.
Hey, man. I used to have conversations with people about this.
Yeah.
You know, I always, shit, my name is Mark Foster, so I used to get picked on about my name or whatever. Uh-huh. So, I'd be picking on people about people's names.
Motherfucker.
Exactly. Steve Stevens.
Yeah.
That's like Robert Robinson.
Yeah.
Or
yeah. Right.
Like, how lazy could you be to put his first name and his last name at the same time?
Yeah, that is dumb lazy.
So
right.
that's an L for Steve Stevens' parents already.
It's an L for Steve Stevens. Your life was set up to be fucking a failure.
Yeah. So what they said, he was, oh yeah, like, I think we already covered it. Like, he was pissed off about his girlfriend not picking up the phone or some junk like that, and he was sitting there talking about it all calm, like, yo, man, you know, I talk to people and you know, they, people not respecting me, and, you know, I've been a savage, and all kind of square nonsense.
At this point, I'm feeling like it's just excuses as to why he did what he did.
Yeah.
I'm still sticking to the point where I feel like Steve Stevenson's, or Stevie Steve, as I call him,
mm-hmm,
you know what I'm saying, being the bitch ass nigga he is, couldn't handle his female, and he took it out on somebody else.
Right, GG, real psycho. GG say Steve Stevens is a real psycho.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Yo, didn't somebody do that? Somebody did that. I can't recall his name, but he did that down here in South Florida when the news anchor, he was the cameraman.
Oh, the black dude that
wanted
to kill the cameraman?
Right, right.
And the lady.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, he was the cameraman. He killed the anchors.
Yes.
So I'm like, damn, you know
what I'm saying? He killed an anchor and a cameraman.
Oh, okay, that's what it was.
Yeah,
but he was also a cameraman too. Now,
oh, I don't know what the hell.
Yeah,
he
yeah,
was.
He shot he two crazy. People. I recall that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So immediately off rip, I was just like, another bruh doing something else crazy. What is going on?
Yeah.
You know
so
I mean?
he talked all this gangster shit about how he gonna off a whole bunch of people, and he gonna off as much people as he can before he get caught, whatever, whatever. And that led to what? How long did it take for him to find him? 2 days?
2 days, yeah, 2 days.
He was was in Columbus, and he actually went to what it was, Philly or something like that.
Yeah, those, Philadelphia, which is crazy, like, because he was a black dude with a beard. Like, there's nothing but black dudes with beards in Philly. So I was scared for every black dude with a beard in Philly at this point.
He was blending in them bushes.
Yeah, man. I shaved that, you know what I'm saying, that week. I was like, yo, I'm shaving. I don't want to be mistaken. You know what I mean? That's crazy.
Ended up down here.
Yeah. If you look like Suge Knight or Uncle Phil, you're in danger.
So this coward ended up killing himself.
Yeah.
After talking all that nonsense about how many people, well, he said he killed like 13, 14 people already, and he was like naming locations and whatever, whatever.
Yeah.
And they ended up killing himself because obviously he wasn't built to do that time that
right,
he was
going
to
do. Right.
So he was just there talking on camera like about, you know, death row, this, that, and the third, whatever, whatever.
Yeah.
So, you know what I mean? He killed himself.
Yeah.
So that leads us to his victim, right?
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you saw this or not, and I wanted to kind of get your thoughts on it.
I'm just here to do a podcast. What did you see?
The victim now is a 74-year-old man, 72 or 74, one of the two. Uh-huh. R.I.P. to him, first of all.
Yeah, definitely. R.I.P. to him. My condolences go out to his family.
Yeah.
Yeah. What was his name? Do you recall?
I
don't. Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it.
Homie. That's going to be everybody in that way.
We don't remember your name. You homie.
Homie.
So old man homie.
Yeah. So homie.
Old man homie.
Like, this is what happened to him. Now, as news outlets usually do, when something bad happens on the news, they start digging up dirt.
Yeah.
Right? So they dug up some dirt on this dude, and they found out that when he was 54 years old, he got a 16-year-old pregnant.
What?
Yeah.
Wait. So old man homie, at 54 years old, he got a 16-year-old girl pregnant.
Yes. Because he has 9 children, right? Uh-huh. So, you know, obviously, if he got 9 children, they want to find out who the family is, this, that, and the third, and they go down the line.
and
they
like,
found out his youngest baby mama is 30 years old.
Wow. So
I believe, if I'm not mistaken, they have either they said that the girl was 16 when he was messing with her, or that they have a 16-year-old child together, but they have 2 kids together.
Uh-huh.
So I believe either the youngest one is 16 or something like that, but they have, you know what I mean, a child together.
So
two children together.
Two children. Okay. So how we know this wasn't consensual though? Was it or wasn't it?
All right. So that this is my point now.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that though? 54 years old. Messing with a 16-year-old.
Oh man.
Give me your thoughts on that, man.
Man, listen.
And mind you,
I'm just keeping
both of us have daughters.
But fuck, dog. Really, you had to go bring him in, my nigga?
I'm just saying.
All right, listen.
I'm just saying, you got to put that into perspective when we talk about this.
All right, okay. So I'm going to put that in perspective. Both of us have daughters. Okay. I'm just going to tell you like this. Like, you know what I'm saying? If anybody has ever watched like Game of Thrones, or, you know, have you ever seen like what happens in the Hindu religion and all that type of stuff? You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes like people have daughters and they might feel like, look, I can't take care of my daughter, or I can't take care of my family. But maybe somebody else that can, maybe I'll offer them up to this person.
Okay.
So I don't know. I'm just assuming. America, I'm just assuming this. So what if they say like, yo, look, man, you know, I'm offering up my daughter to you. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, for that, you return some favors to us.
I kind of get what you're saying.
Right.
But we know that that didn't happen in this
situation. How do we know?
Because.
How do we know?
It's a young black girl from the inner city.
Uh-huh. I'm saying though, so anybody could have gotten, why did this young black girl choose this 51-year-old to get down.
That's not the right question.
Okay. What is the right question then, my nigga? You tell me.
What is Minority Report when it did that? You're asking the wrong question. The right question is, why is this old ass man messing with a 16-year-old girl?
My nigga, I'm asking this in 2000. So this had to take place in 2000.
That's so modern day America.
So no, I'm not asking that question. You asking that question. I'm asking, why did this 16-year-old mess with this old man?
She's a child, dude. She's a child.
Okay.
When I say child, I don't want to make it seem like, all right, you know, she's like 7-year-old child. Like, nah. Yeah. She's still a child.
Yeah.
At 16 years old.
But dude, 50 though.
Yes.
Okay, so what can a 50-year-old tell a 16-year-old that could convince a 16-year-old to go ahead and
dash? Dude, I don't think that he can tell her anything. Mm-hmm. A young girl in the right mind.
Yeah.
She might have been low self-esteem, whatever the case is. I don't know.
Uh-huh.
I don't know what it is.
What was that viewer saying?
She said, I don't think he can justify it.
You're right, viewer. But how?
He can't justify it.
Yeah.
He cannot justify this.
Uh-huh.
I can't justify it. Uh-huh. Nobody can't justify this. This is, like I said, this is modern day America.
Uh-huh.
She is 16 years old and he's 50 something. Mm-hmm. That's rape, dude.
I hear you. It is rape. In the eyes of the law, it is definitely rape. Now, keep in mind, morally, like, who set this moral standpoint? Like, I'm not saying this is what I want to do or this is something I do. It's not something I believe. No, I don't believe in. I do have a daughter. I don't want nobody having sex with my daughter, period.
Exactly.
Period at all. I hope she's like the Virgin Mary and just has a baby, like, miraculously.
Exactly.
You see what I'm saying?
Exactly. But,
however, like, you know what I'm saying? These things are happening out there. So, like, again, I don't know why a 16-year-old and a 50-year-old man would get together, but there was a point in time where people were having babies at 14, 15
that
years old.
That time has passed.
That time
where, where it was acceptable for that to happen.
Uh-huh.
Okay. That was in the 1800s.
But who made that rule, though? Who said that this is what it is?
Over time, people become more civilized, mm-hmm. and you realize that certain shit is wrong, man.
Man, listen, man. It's always a bitch ass nigga to change the game. Somebody saying this ain't fair, and change the game. They made the rules different.
And I mean, I understand, and I don't want to be naive to make it seem like I don't understand that stuff like this is not going on in everyday America,
right.
All over the United States.
Right.
I understand that stuff like this is happening,
uh-huh.
but it still don't make it right, though.
Nah. It don't. So,
and then the reason why I don't want to try to get too much into this.
I'm just playing devil's advocate out here, y'all.
I don't want to try to get into this too much.
I'm trying to give y'all a little something else to think about.
But I'm asking is that now, given the fact that you know this now,
uh-huh.
does that change the way about how you feel about him getting killed?
No, I do not feel like, yo, listen, man, if somebody roll up on me and pop me right now, like, I'm sure y'all gonna come up with some skeletons in my fucking closet. And I'm sure that's true for a lot of people out here.
Alright, so with him now, you know why they did that too?
Because he black.
That's the reason number one.
Uh-huh.
But also, I guess the family got on TV, mm-hmm. and they painted this picture of him like, you know, he was just, you know, all God fearing man and this, that, and the third. And
so
like,
what?
He was the best.
What,
like,
are you saying? When you die, somebody should just tell the truth?
Nah.
Man, he was a fuck nigga. I'm sorry he died, but I was a fuck nigga, dog.
Exactly.
I don't know why somebody killed his dad earlier.
Gigi said he could be a grandfather. You damn right he could be a grandfather.
Yeah, he's old enough to be anybody's grandfather. You know what I'm saying? And just to see him with the little.
He could probably be a great grandfather, right. You're talking about nowadays.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. That's wild.
You know what I mean?
That's wild.
That's crazy, right?
That is crazy. GG, what up? Come on the podcast. But
for real.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, my man had the little Walmart plastic bag, like, yo, chill. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was a sensitive situation because, you know, like I said before, like, anytime somebody could picture themselves in a scenario where some terrible act happened,
yeah,
immediately they get scared.
Mm-hmm.
And just to see somebody that was minding their business, and mm-hmm. somebody just randomly like, yo,
yeah,
oh shit, there goes an old man, I'm gonna come through and shoot this motherfucker right there.
Yeah.
And you know what I mean, shoot him on camera. That people are in fear of that. That mm-hmm. that could happen to anybody. You could be yeah. out jogging, you could be out anywhere minding your business, and somebody just randomly decide today is the day that I can't take it no more, and you're gonna be my victim.
Yeah.
You but, know what I'm saying?
I mean, I guess to answer my own question,
yeah,
I feel like that changed the way I feel about him dying. It does. It does.
My nigga, so dude, hold on. Wait,
you know how I feel
wait.
About this, dude.
Wait. You know how I know. I know subject. Personally how you feel about this.
And
dub,
everybody and who listens to this podcast episode after episode, yeah. they know how I feel about it too.
Yeah. But I know how deep this gets for you.
Yeah.
However, are you telling me like, yo, because of that, dude deserves to die?
No, I'm not saying that.
So what are
I'm
you
saying?
That
he didn't deserve to go out like that.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's karma coming back to him.
Nigga, I'm gonna leave you alone with that one right there, my nigga.
Like I said, I don't feel like he deserved to uh-huh. die like that.
Yeah,
but I feel like it's karma. I feel like it's that negative energy coming back to him. Man.
Negative energy came back to Pops. And I'm saying, like I said before, everybody out there have mm-hmm. done something negative, one point or another in their
of
life.
Of course. Of course.
So you think but you feel like we all need to get shot by Stevie Steve bitch ass?
Nah, I feel like
I'm not capable of defending myself.
I feel like it's extremes to the negativity that you do in your life.
Uh huh.
Yeah, you know what
there's
I'm saying.
Levels
you,
to
you,
this shit.
Yes, it's levels to it. You know what I mean. You probably stepped on a roach or you know what I mean. Yeah, whatever. Yeah. You know what I mean. Killed a duckling when you was a little kid or something like that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean. That's different than
yeah
what he doing. Or what he did.
Uh-huh.
To
fuck that. Stevie Steve was a bitch ass motherfucker. Stevie Steve went out there and picked on somebody that was incapable of defending mm-hmm. himself, was incapable of running, was no threat to him at this point in time, and he just shot the man in broad daylight mm-hmm. because he was mad that his girl wasn't giving him pussy no more. Stevie Steve is the real bitch ass motherfucker in this scenario. This old man. You know what I'm saying? Like,
he is.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, we all have done some shit. Like, we can't be out here judging, and we can't be out here, like, you know what I'm saying, wishing bad karma on people.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
I'm not looking at it like that. I'm not looking at it the way you are.
All right, so on to Aaron Hernandez.
Yeah.
So, everybody who know or don't know, Aaron Hernandez uh-huh. was a player for the Patriots.
Yeah.
Probably on his way to be one of the best tight ends. He was a tight end, right?
Mm-hmm.
Probably one of the best.
He was
tight
out there with the boy
league.
Gronkowski. He would have been Gronkowski.
Yeah, he was definitely on his way. And then he two, three years ago,
yeah.
he got convicted for the murder of Odin Lloyd.
Yeah,
that whole fiasco, whatever. So he's been in prison now for a little while.
Uh-huh.
They just brought him up on some new charges where I guess two or three other people had got killed.
Yeah.
Some kind of OG Bobby Johnson situation in the hood where supposedly he did like a drive-by or something crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And he just beat those charges.
Right.
So he just got off for those charges, found innocent. And then now, pretty much like 2 days after the trial or whatever.
Yeah, he went ahead and killed himself.
Yeah.
Wow. What is it? Wow. So how do you feel about that, Mr. Karma?
This could be karma coming back to him as well.
Uh-huh.
But a lot of people is clowning him, right?
Clowning him? Like how? How they clowning him?
Yo, the internet is going nuts. So
nothing is safe these days.
Not at all. Yeah. So niggas came up with this this you know how you play Hangman.
Oh shit.
So it's like a Hangman picture floating around the internet.
Uh-huh.
where they got like it spaces in between the name Aaron Hernandez or whatever, and the Hangman is like halfway there.
That is funny. That is very funny. I can't say.
But
I can't
should we
laugh.
Be laughing at the man for killing himself though?
I mean, look, I listen.
Is it on the flip side of the other situation, right?
Uh-huh, yeah.
Did he? Can we look at him and say, good for you?
I'm not gonna say good for you because I am not.
Because we spoke about suicide before on here.
We spoke about suicide, but however, I'm fucking subscribing to what you were saying before.
Uh-oh.
Well, sometimes some people get what they deserve, you know what I'm saying? And Aaron Hernandez, like, he had a bright future. He was very athletic. You had a promising future with the Patriots.
Uh-huh.
You know, why did you get yourself involved in all this? Why?
I guess it's some kind of street life allure that these dudes can't seem to get away from.
And that's the thing. I can't feel sorry for a rapper that gets in trouble. A rapper that has the potential of making millions of dollars.
Uh-huh.
And I can't feel sorry for an athlete that gets in trouble who's making millions of dollars. I can never feel sorry for these people.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I can't.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because you're blessed with the opportunity that the average man isn't.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever you need to escape from, whatever you need to get away from, I personally can't see myself not being able to separate myself from these things.
Mm-hmm.
So how are you caught up in with all this shit?
I don't know, man. Like, you know? I said, I never lived the street life. I never wanted to live the street life. I don't know what the allure is. I don't know. But now with him killing himself too, they say it's like some loopholes in Massachusetts law where.
Uh-huh.
If as far as his family is concerned, as far as his assets are concerned, right?
Mm-hmm.
He had a contract with the Patriots. When he got convicted of murder, they voided the contracts.
Yeah.
So he was like, I think it was like $4 million guaranteed left on the contract.
Yeah.
Then he had some kind of NFL pension and retirement and whatever. So it's amounting to somewhere about $10 million right now.
Yeah.
Where now, because of the law that they have in Massachusetts, if you are convicted of a crime, right?
Yeah.
And then you die appealing that conviction, they can then go back and say you never got convicted of that crime. In layman's terms, that's the short version of the law.
Did Aaron Hernandez do an honorable thing?
For his family... He did. Because now it puts his family in a better position, especially his daughter.
Right.
At the end of all of this, you know, yeah, Hernandez was a piece of shit.
Yeah.
But a wife lost a husband.
Yeah.
And a daughter lost a father.
Yeah.
So as the family, you know, unfortunately, your dad and your husband was not that great of a guy.
Yeah.
But
okay. You know. Well, now, wow, man. Good looks on that. I never really got to look at it from that perspective before.
Yeah.
And yeah, I would say in that instance, and I'm saying if I'm guilty already, why am I going to serve 100? I'm serving life.
Mm-hmm.
I never got to when they say life plus fucking 100 years or life plus 20 years or life plus, man, I'm here forever.
Like, well, I guess in some states though, I'm not sure how it goes in Massachusetts or whatever, but in some states when they say life, it doesn't necessarily mean
click that off and start it again.
It doesn't necessarily mean that you're gonna serve your entire life on doing time or whatever.
Yeah.
Sometimes it means that you can do it for 25 years and you're eligible for parole and this, that, and the third.
Yeah.
So in that sense, we look at it and we say, okay, did he do this specifically for his daughter?
Yeah.
Did he do this for his wife?
Now, I'm really thinking about, like, you know, all the newscasters, all the sportscasters and everybody, all the sports anchors and everybody, everybody I've known personally that knows about this incident or this situation with Aaron Hernandez have said, yo, what a waste, you know, what a waste for somebody like him to do something like that and waste their life. And I would suppose if I was somebody like that and everybody speaking on my life under those terms, you know, at some point I would feel like, yo, damn, I really fucked up.
Of course.
I really fucked up and there's no coming back from this.
But,
so what is there for me to live for? Why would I want to stay in jail for 100 years? I'm in jail for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
I've lost millions of dollars.
Yeah.
I've lost so much opportunity to be a great.
My family out here suffering.
My name, everything is discredited. What else do I have to live for? Ultimately, that is just, what is there?
And then he was, what, 27 years old?
Right.
So, and then now, even with that now, the family of the guy that he got convicted of killing, they have a civil lawsuit against him.
Yeah.
So, it's a whole bunch of different things going on here where if he's found liable or whatever, if he found guilty in the civil lawsuit, they can get X amount of dollars.
Yeah.
So that money that might be freed up to the family might have to his family, to Aaron Hernandez's family, might end up going to Odin Lloyd's family if they win their case. Mm-hmm. So now it's a whole bunch of legal situations going on where the Aaron Hernandez's family is going to have to go and fight just to see if they can get money and whatever, whatever, so that they can be more well off and this, that, and the third. Yeah. So it's one big situation going on. So I guess the end result of all of that now is for him to do what he did. Do you think that he knew all of this before he committed suicide?
I mean, I'm pretty sure he was able to afford some good lawyers. So I'm pretty sure somebody informed him of what's going on. And I'm really thinking that's what he did it for.
So you think he did it for his family to be
it for his family, man.
Put them in a better situation.
Yeah, I really do. I really do. I really do. However, though.
Teacher Wagwan.
Yeah, teacher Wagwan, yo. Good luck. Yo, everybody that needs somebody to repair their car, if you're down here in the South Florida, Broward area, yo, shouts out to my man, Teacher. You know what I mean? Hit us up on Bootleg Kid Podcast. We get you the information. My man, Teacher, come through.
Follow that boy on Instagram. You know,
follow that boy on Instagram.
_TEACHA81.
Lawyer Bootleg Cable Podcast listener.
Yes, sir.
All right, so get back to what we were saying. All right. So now I'm talking to a couple of people at work, right?
Yeah.
And we're talking about the old Aaron Hernandez thing. And before I could get about three sentences in, somebody popped out of nowhere and said, man, it was a setup.
What was a setup?
Somebody killed him in jail.
Why?
I don't know.
Well, it's a lot of reasons why people get murked in prison. Right. So I can't really, But what was that person's reason saying that?
I don't know. It was just like, yo, there was a hit out for him, and they set him up. And you know what I'm saying? They send these police officers in his jail cell to take him out of there.
So
I wasn't really trying to get into too much reasons why they was asking.
Yeah.
But immediately I just became very uncomfortable. I'm like, yo, what the fuck again? Like, why is everything these days have to be a conspiracy?
that kind of goes in line with the old dude getting killed.
Yeah, back to the man Stevie Steve.
And
old man homie
getting
killed.
Yeah, people
said that Steve Stevenson's incident was fake.
Yeah,
I mean, some of their claim is, why was this old man shot? The camera went away for a second,
and then when it came back
to Steve Stevenson's, there was no blood on the camera lens. There was no blood on Steve Stevenson. Yeah. They saying, how did he get from point A to point B?
How was he bleeding so much in that short of time?
How did Steve Stevenson get from point A to point B without being caught by officers? And the fact that, how did he put up these videos without being caught? And yeah, that's something you and I were talking about the other day. It's like, why does the fuck everything needs to be a conspiracy? Like, is it because weed is legal?
So you think people just out here thinking about it a little bit more?
Yeah, smoking too much. Everybody's just too fucking paranoid these days, it feels like.
I agree.
People are forgetting logics and common sense points in certain situations where they just like, yo, everything has to be a conspiracy.
In 2017,
the Illuminati is out to get us.
I guess they was out to get Hernandez too.
They out to get Hernandez.
For what?
I don't know.
So y'all got him now, Illuminati. They never,
that's what, like you said, you made a good point to me the other day.
Mm-hmm.
For what? They never have a really good point as to why.
So Aaron Hernandez is out here trying to distract us.
Yeah, it's a distraction.
Steve Stevens is out here trying to distract us
from certain things. For what?
From what?
From what? Come on, somebody answer me. Go ahead, hit us up on the subscription. You know what I'm saying? Comment on the YouTube video that you see right now.
Comment
please
on the
tell us for what.
Yeah.
Please tell us for what. And I don't want to hear about devil worshiping or any of those things. You know what I mean? Tell me legitly for what.
Yeah.
For what?
For anybody watching on IG Live right now, man.
Right.
For what? What's the reason why people these whole conspiracy theorist people.
Yeah.
What's the reason behind the conspiracy? What's the end goal?
Yeah. Why? For what?
If Steve Stevens killing homie.
Homie.
Old man homie. Was some kind of conspiracy, and it was fake, and it was this, that, and the third. What are we being distracted from that made us pay attention to Steve Stevens? What are we being distracted from
that made
us pay attention to Aaron Hernandez?
That's a very good question.
Could tell us that.
Again, I'm not saying there isn't a secret society out there. I'm not saying. I don't know if they call the Illuminati. I'm pretty sure they would have changed their name by now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying that there's some think tanks out there. If you really break it down, if people got the money and the power, there's certain things that out there they can do.
Yeah.
But again, certain things that happen in life, not everything is a damn conspiracy.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm tired of people making everything out to be a conspiracy. Every time a football team wins, every time a baseball team wins, every time a basketball team wins, oh yeah, it was a conspiracy. Because I'm like, yo, shut the fuck up, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, nothing happens real in life anymore. Is that what you're telling me right now?
I guess not.
Yeah.
Like, yo, I guess not.
I don't get it, man. I really don't get it, man.
This week, man, though, it's before we came on here and started, started a podcast or whatever, we was talking about all the stuff that happened this week.
Yeah.
This other shooter in Fresno, California, black dude. What's up with these black dudes that's out here going commando, killing a whole bunch of people? What's going on with that? Like, I feel like that's like a trend now.
Is it?
Because isn't it used to be the white boys that was doing that before.
Yeah.
And it seemed like now all of a sudden it's just like, you know, you got what's his name? Dorner. What was his name again?
Hey yo, real quick, teacher, we love you. We love you too, bro. But yeah, man, what happened in Fresno?
This dude killed three white dudes. It was a black dude, but I guess he was like a Muslim, or he's some kind of radical Islam type dude or whatever. Yeah. And I guess he made like anti-white comments and posts on different social media platforms or whatever.
Yeah.
And then he decided to go out and just kill three random white dudes. He was trying to kill, I guess, as many dudes as he can, but somehow he was able to get taken alive or whatever, whatever. But yeah, man, murk three dudes.
What? Wow.
Anti-white,
so was he black or Muslim? Like, he looked like a nigga.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Like homie from down the street.
Damn, black and mild moment for us. Like, what's going on?
Black and mild moment for this whole week, bro.
Yo, for real. It's been some Paris, wild.
Some Paris. How many people got killed in Paris?
Quite a few got killed in Paris.
I think it was more than 10.
Yeah. Something like that. And I think police officers too. Yeah.
Yeah, man. It's just wild week. You know what, I was trying to find like some positive news before I came on.
We were.
And then I found it.
What was the positive news you found?
Bill O'Reilly got murked from Fox News.
That's not positive, my nigga.
Why is that not positive, dude?
Yo, Bill O'Reilly is gonna make a podcast.
I'm pretty sure he
and
is.
He's gonna be our competition out here. Like, yo, Bill O'Reilly, yo, think about
wouldn't
it.
Just
the same way Howard Stern did it.
Wouldn't that be crazy, though?
Yeah.
If he made a podcast.
And he's going to get his followers. People that fuck with Bill O'Reilly is not going to stop fucking with Bill O'Reilly.
God. Damn, dude, you just put me on to something, man.
Bill O'Reilly's going to fuck us up.
He gonna be like those two, and he gonna be able to say it too.
Yeah,
those two niggas out there in Coral Springs that been talking shit. B double and kill, I'm coming for you.
Yeah, bootleg cable podcast. Now let's talk about bootleg for a second. That is illegal. Fucking Bill O'Reilly.
Bill O'Reilly go try to murk us, dude.
Yeah, for real. Anybody who follows Bill O'Reilly is gonna consistently follow Bill O'Reilly. He's been talking shit forever.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I seen Ludacris on the Breakfast Club, and Ludacris was like, oh, look at that. You know, all these sponsors are pulling away from Bill O'Reilly after Bill O'Reilly done shitted on us for shitting on me, referring to Ludacris for his Pepsi commercial and all that. And Pepsi pulled Ludacris off the Pepsi ad. However, now he's caught in all this controversy. You know what I'm saying? As far as
I know it was all sexual harassment, but I didn't really take a look into it that much. But what did they say that he actually did? Like, was he, grabbing him by the pussy? Was he pulling a Trump out here?
Yeah.
Was he out here trumping?
Yeah, I think he. No, I think somebody actually said that he's made, you know, advances on him, on them.
But he didn't actually assault anybody, though.
I don't know. I don't know. Mm. I don't know. I really don't know. Mm. I don't know.
But they might say.
All I know is this: like, look, I was watching. I was at work the other day, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this shit was kind of funny to me.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So I'm at work, and I'm watching. The View, I think it was one of them fucking shows with all the females on it.
Mm-hmm.
And they put up a clip of Billy Bush. Now, for those of us who don't know who Billy Bush was, Billy Bush is the news anchor that was on Access Hollywood
with Donald Trump.
With Donald Trump on the bus,
laughing about grabbing him by the pussy.
Grabbing him by the pussy. Now, the joke
they let you do anything.
The joke prior to that was fuck her right in the pussy. But Donald Trump took it a step further and said, yeah, I just grabbing bitches by the pussy, right? So Billy Bush,
mm-hmm,
made a little Instagram video, and he's singing the song talking about, yo, Billy Bush is trying to get back on TV, but they won't let me. Something along those lines.
He made this song.
He made this. It was a song that he kind of like changed the words in to apply to what he's trying to say on Instagram, right?
Okay.
Right. So he's singing it. How's he getting a haircut?
Mm-hmm.
So people are saying it was a creepy song that he made. It's a creepy video for him to put out there in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
So the people on The View were kind of laughing, like, he does not deserve another chance to be on television.
Why?
Billy Bush does not deserve another chance to be on television, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm in there, and a couple of my coworkers, you know, I just got to say it, they were white.
Uh-huh.
They were there, and they're commenting, and they say, "Duck." Yeah, he does not deserve a chance to be on television for doing such a creepy thing and, you know, grabbing by the pussy. This is wrong, da da da. But I know for a fact that these white coworkers that were saying this, and I'm Bootleg Cable Podcast listeners out there, I'm not exaggerating. I know for a fact that they voted for Donald Trump.
Okay.
So what I'm trying to say is this.
You voted for the man that actually said that he was doing this. You gave him the chance to be president of the United States.
Hold the highest office in the country.
But you don't want to let this man go on news and talk about celebrities and talk, because Billy Bush wasn't reporting no real fucking news.
Right.
But you let the nigga that's out here advocating, grabbing him by the pussy, hold the highest office in the land.
Dog.
Moment of silence for that.
For real, I really, that is moment of silence.
Moment of silence for that shit.
That is moment of silence. That's wild to me. Like, you know, people pick and choose what the fuck they want to be mad about.
Mm.
Donald Trump is holding the highest office right now.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, we could potentially be going to war.
World War III.
Missiles getting sent at us, B.
Yeah. Yeah, and you worried, and you denying Billy Bush a job.
And you all Billy Bush and me on TV.
Yo, people got their priorities fucked up, man. Yo,
fuck the fuck up, man. Yo, now that you said the shit about that officer, everybody in that room feels to me like that fucking officer that pulls you over. That they just, you know, they just want to hold somebody to fuck accountable.
For something.
For something.
Mm.
For something. It doesn't matter.
How dare you try to get ahead in traffic?
How dare you try to grab women by the pussy? But you know what? We need somebody to tell these niggas they ain't shit. Yeah. So Donald Trump,
yeah,
you become president.
Yeah.
Word. Word.
That's crazy, man.
Yo, man.
Crazy shit, man.
Yo, that is just on some kind of sad, man. That is some kind of sad. What else? Hey, yo, Bill O'Reilly's gonna have a podcast.
He's getting
his money, and he's gonna have a podcast. Sirius
XM probably might hire him or something.
Somebody's gonna hire him. So he.
Before we get off of him, recently I saw a video where he was interviewing Cameron and Dame Dash back in the days. Mm-hmm. Did you see that one?
Mm-mm.
Y'all go out and watch that. It's an interview with Cam, and Cam was clowning on Bill.
For real? Cam,
yeah, he was clowning on him because Bill was trying to make it seem like, okay, kids are listening to you, and you know, you're spewing all of this, you know, ignorant whatever, and you're a detriment to your community, and this, and the third, and Cam was like, yo, man, I'm an entrepreneur. Like, you know, I made it out of the hood. I'm starring in movies. I'm doing this. I'm doing that. Dame Dash was making a point that Cam is the head of his own label and he's, you know, giving people jobs and this, that, and the third, yeah, and whatever, whatever. But Bill was trying to make it, you know, as negative as he always does with every situation involving black people and especially with rap music. But it was definitely a hilarious interview, man. It's probably about eight minutes long, yeah, something like that. Y'all go check that out. Google it and check it out if you get a chance, all right, or whatever.
For sure.
Moving on, the boy Mello cheated on Lala supposedly. Mm. Supposedly with a stripper.
It was a stripper?
Yeah, they said it was a stripper. Oh, supposedly, allegedly. Mello. Allegedly he went raw.
What? Yeah, and he got her pregnant?
Allegedly she's pregnant.
Yo. Man, yo, shout out to the boy Ro. I've been listening to Ro music all day. And Ro said a lot of shit about fucking Ran Rubbers. Yo, for those for those who don't know about Ro, man, we gonna have a Ro interview coming up, yeah, on Bootleg Cable Podcast. Check that out.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? We're gonna kill that.
Definitely. But it's gonna be entertaining. We're gonna have a good time.
Definitely, we're gonna have a good time.
Shout out to the boy Ro, man.
Yeah, shout out to him.
Dollars and deals.
So this dude is knocking down the stripper without no R piece.
Yes, sir. Barebacking it.
Hey, yo, listen, man. All right, let me just say this. I've always felt this way about Carmelo Anthony. But, you know what I'm saying? I know it's blasphemy to speak against certain athletes or whatever, whatever. I always felt like Carmelo Anthony was kind of like Mike Tyson or, you know what I'm saying, one of them people that we want to see win.
Yeah.
But we know ain't shit.
What made you come to that conclusion?
I just always felt like Carmelo Anthony is somebody that everybody wanted to see win, but secretly, you know, he ain't shit. And I always felt like that about Carmelo Anthony. I just always felt like this dude, I see his game on the court. I see his lackadaisical efforts on playing defense. And I see he was always a, you know what I'm saying, he was always selfish on the court.
Yeah.
As far as, you know what I'm saying, he has to have the ball. He's taking all the shots. Yeah. He's not really getting all that many assists. And I always felt like Carmelo Anthony was just somebody that everybody like wanted to see him win because they saw themselves in Carmelo Anthony. However, he ain't shit.
I wouldn't say that. I'd have to disagree with you on that.
Okay, go ahead and disagree with me.
With this one now, it's a lifestyle, bro.
Yeah.
I feel like as a woman or as a man, I don't know what women do or what famous women do or whatever. We definitely know what famous men and what famous men do.
Yeah.
And famous athletes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Athletes are known to have multiple women. I feel like if you are a woman and you're getting into a relationship with a famous athlete,
yeah,
especially one that a lot of women like, because a lot of women seem to be attracted to Carmelo, especially when he first came out of the league.
Yeah, you got a name like Carmelo.
You know what I mean? He definitely had a lot of. He was lady friendly.
I'm Carmelo and I look like I could dance a bachata. I'm fucking getting bitches.
Yeah.
I'm a nigga and I look like I do bachata. I'm getting bitches.
Yeah. So he's definitely lady friendly.
Yeah.
He was definitely a desired guy.
Yeah.
Especially, you know, when he first came out and he first jumped on the scene. I think as a woman, you should accept that.
Wait, what? Yeah. Can you say that again, please?
I feel like as a woman, let me be clear.
Yeah,
as a woman who is getting into a relationship with a famous athlete, you should expect that you're gonna get cheated on. And I really, really mean that.
You. So hold up. So you agree with Carmelo's statement? Is what you said.
I don't know if that statement. What was the statement again? I don't know if it was true.
Okay, the statement is online. So if it's online, it's true. Fuck it. It's true. The statement was
allegedly.
I'm not married. She is.
Body that shit.
Yo.
And I don't agree with it.
I'm not married. No, you don't agree with that. I don't agree with it. P double. Mark Foster.
Yeah.
You don't agree with it.
Nah.
But being Carmelo, sounds like you agree with it.
But
so you saying if I'm an athlete
And then I'm in a position to get a bunch of bitches. And then I'm gonna get bitches. But it's not like a situation. You know what? Yeah. It would be uh-huh. different if it was a situation where, like, uh-huh. say he was like, they was like together from when they was broke up until.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like Kendrick Lamar and his girl, supposedly. Yeah. Like she been there.
Yeah.
For a while. Like LeBron and his girl.
Which is smart on Kendrick's part, because Kendrick hasn't gotten married to his girl yet, technically, right?
I'm not sure.
He's been his fiance for like forever.
Okay.
As far as I understand.
But like LeBron and his wife. They've been together forever.
Yeah.
So in that situation, mm-hmm. I guess at the end of the day, if you get married, it should be some kind of loyalty between you and your wife.
Yeah.
So on one end of the spectrum, I say Carmella is wrong for cheating on her, because if you thought you was ready to get married or whatever, if you wasn't ready to get married,
man, listen.
Or like Jay-Z said,
yo, don't be treating the one that you're loving with the same disrespect. Don't even treat the one that you humping with the same respect that you're giving the one that you're loving. Ain't about that. Yo, listen.
And he also said,
yeah, what does he say?
Act like an adult to have an affair for once.
Listen, ain't nothing wrong with an affair, but you always gotta know what the deal is.
But obviously there is something wrong with an affair if you out here, like you said.
Yeah. I think that's for the niggas that ain't got no dick, bro.
Hitting the raw.
Yo, if you can't really fuck the shit out of a bitch like the right way, I think that you gotta find another way to win. And I would venture to say that, yo, for Carmella to go as far as fucking getting a stripper pregnant,
he need to take the Derrick Rose playbook on this one.
My nigga, you cannot tell me you're in the NBA.
Make sure that rubber never leave your sight.
Right. That yo.
You're, right. You don't want the turkey baster situation going on.
Yo. For real, my nigga. Like yo, Carmelo. Yo, for real. Like I feel like Carmelo ain't fucking this. He ain't fucking right. You know what I'm saying? And my nigga, if you felt like you need to take the rubber off, mm-hmm. and you went as far as letting off in this bitch,
we wasn't there, so we don't know if he was letting off or not. You know?
My nigga, how do you get a bitch pregnant though?
Might have been a turkey baster in the room, son.
I don't believe that shit. You know what I'm saying?
She was siphoning the nut. Listen, Carmelo,
you can't be out here, you know what I'm saying, fucking a bitch. You gotta be out here giving a bitch dick. You know what I'm saying? You had to be out here giving her dick, not fucking her. And I feel like Carmelo wasn't fucking this bitch, dog. Like, yo, Carmelo, it's a stripper, my nigga. Like, yo, why would you go as far as to take a rubber off on a stripper, my nigga? That's the last bitch.
They're all respectable women here.
That's the last. The
podcast.
Hey, listen.
Forgive my co-host for calling y'all bitches.
Yo, I'm girl, women out there, yo, just like Jay-Z said, there's women and there's bitches. You know what I mean?
Let's describe a certain female.
Bitch, you ain't a bitch, you ain't you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, listen, there's a difference. You know what I mean? And if you out here and you're a stripper, I'm sorry. I understand not all strippers or bitches.
Some of them do have tuition to pay.
Not all strippers. Or you know what I'm saying? Not all strippers are really out here just stripping to pay tuition, or
some
not all strippers
do.
Are trying to, you know what I'm saying?
Books is expensive, bro.
Yeah, you're right. What I'm saying is that story is not true for every female out here.
How the state tuition fees is high.
What I'm saying is I'm not trying to be the nigga to decide which story is true and which story is not.
Yeah.
You a stripper? Yo, you off limits as a bitch that I want to fuck raw. Period. I don't give a fuck.
I agree. That's what I'm saying. It might have been a turkey baster situation going on, bro.
I don't know.
He wasn't there.
I don't know. Yo, I can't. Like I said,
either way,
Carmella, you should have took the condom with you. And went home.
If this is the sole cause of them breaking up or whatever, yeah. Either way, Mello, I think that you fucked up.
Yeah, you fucked up, man.
Because and you know, it's rumors going around talking about, you know, I guess. Him being mad about her and the scene that she had with dude off of Power, and you know, this, that, and the third. But
word,
yeah, but
yeah, Power is a good show, it's coming back soon,
yeah, June,
yeah, June, yeah.
But I don't know, man. Melo, I think you messed up, you need to be a six man coming off the bench.
You need to be an Andre Iguodala out here.
It's a different situation if the marriage just didn't work. But for you to go out and get the stripper knocked up, like that was foul.
So boy. Yo, Lala got cheated on.
Yeah.
Motherfucking Halle Berry got cheated on.
Yeah.
Yo, what kind of female do you have to be to not get cheated on?
Every female gets cheated on.
I'm sorry.
Every girls. Type of female gets every type on. Of woman
gets cheated on.
From the most powerful to the least powerful gets cheated on.
Gets cheated on.
So and that so kind of goes in with what I was saying yeah. which to you.
Yeah.
If you are you marrying a professional athlete,
yeah.
The platter that he has to choose from is enormous.
Yeah.
Yes, you are the main course.
Yeah.
But say, man, potatoes. The potatoes is just as good as the steak.
I cannot eat these potatoes.
The potatoes is just as good as the steak, bro.
Stupid. Yeah, these potatoes looking real delicious, yeah, man, right,
you
know, now.
Them green, hey, them green you, beans, right? You want them green beans?
Yeah, I understand,
if
baby.
You don't want them, I'll eat them.
Yeah. I eat them with some steak if you let me.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, that's real talk, man. Listen, ladies, man. And I'm not gonna say this, you know what I'm saying, this is my statement, but this is how it was felt. Like Charlamagne said it best, men do not cheat, you know what I'm saying, for any other reason other than ego. It's ego that makes men cheat.
Yeah. Because you know I can.
Because I can.
Mm-hmm.
And it's
right
new.
Or wrong. Right or wrong.
You know what I'm saying? It's ego.
Yeah.
So I mean, I'm not trying to tell you not to take it personal. But it's not because I don't love you. You know what I'm saying?
And that's another thing too.
Yeah.
A lot of women believe that if you love me, you wouldn't cheat on me. Mm-hmm. This, that, and the third, right? I go by and I'm a married man. Let me just make that clear. You know.
Yeah. Well, no one's supposed too much on here, though.
I'm a married man. No, I'm not going to expose too much. Yeah. And I've had conversations with my wife about this too.
Yeah.
And this is not to say, okay, I'm going to cheat on my wife or whatever the case is. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that human nature, it's natural for you to want more. It's natural for you to want everything.
Yeah.
And I always put this in this perspective. You know what I'm saying? But both of us, we have older cars.
Yeah.
And we have newer cars.
Yeah, I heard this one
right?
you, but go ahead.
So if I have a 2004 Mitsubishi, right? It's getting me from point A to point B.
And I like this car.
It's not giving me no problems. I changed the oil, the gas.
Every time I hit the pedal, it goes.
It goes.
Right.
The system sound nice. The interior
so nice.
Is nice.
AC
this, that,
blowing.
The third. But then just one day, damn,
I see
son.
That.
I see that 2017.
And I know how good this one treats me.
5 Series.
And
BMW.
I know how good my old one treats me.
Yeah.
But I only could wonder.
I just want that new one, though.
That new one, though.
And I got the money to get it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm thinking about that money that I have to get it. I'm like, there's other things in my life that I want.
But I want this new car, though.
So.
And I can get it.
Now, okay. So the other day I was listening to Breakfast Club.
Mm-hmm.
And they were talking about T.I. and they were talking about Flo Rida.
Mm-hmm.
And they was really talking about infidelity, right?
Yeah.
And the question is, his side chicks is out here winning right now.
I think they are, dude.
Yeah?
And the reason why I would say that they are winning is because they're reaping all the benefits of a main chick.
And never got to deal with the problems.
Yeah. All they got to deal with is the social media saying, hey, you're a homewrecker.
You're a homewrecker.
Shame on you.
Yeah, that's why he doesn't have your picture up with me.
Yeah.
Well, what? So?
He's mine. You might have had him
once, but I got him. Yo, they don't know about that song these days, my nigga. One more time. She's mine. You might have had her once, but I got her all the time. Don't try to dry your eyes. She's, yo, word.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They out here, they driving in the night because. Dudes is giving the side chicks hush money.
Yeah.
So if you got to think about it, if you a side chick,
uh-huh.
and you mess around with industry dudes, you know, you're a good looking woman, whatever, whatever. I mean, it's just you kind of prostituting yourself or whatever. Yeah, I would never want anybody to aspire to be the side chick, but you out here, you doing it, whatever, whatever.
Restart that thing. Yeah.
It is what it is.
Yeah, you know what I mean? That's real talk, man. Listen, man. I would say, like, yo, I'm not even gonna say what I want to say because I might expose myself too much.
All right, don't do it. Don't do
but,
it.
But yeah, let's all play our roles out here.
Yeah, definitely.
Let's play our roles.
All right. So speaking of pregnancy, Serena Williams pregnant. Mm. They revealed that recently that I think they said she's 20 weeks pregnant.
Yeah.
And then, you know, people, you know, there's a lot of smart people out here. We able to do math.
Yeah.
They went back in time.
They said when she was with Drake?
No.
What it was in?
They said that when she, I guess it was the French Open recently. Was it the French Open? Uh-huh. Australian Open.
Yeah.
Back in January.
Uh-huh.
She was pregnant when she won the Australian Open.
Oh, wow.
So they use that to show how much of a beast she was or is on the court. But the way they make it seem with that, though, is kind of like, yeah, you know, she did this while she was pregnant. But it's like, yo, like, she wasn't doing it, like, while she was, like, 7 months pregnant or something like that. Like, this is, you know what I'm saying? She probably, just dropped the bomb a couple days or a couple weeks before this happened or whatever. But, you know, salute to Serena and her pregnancy.
Yeah.
But a lot of dudes is out here mad because she was a white dude.
I was going to let you bring that up because I was going to bring that up myself, but I was like, yo, maybe I shouldn't go there because I have no dudes to go in there, right?
Dudes is out here hot that Serena is with a white dude.
Yo, I'm not mad at her. You want me to tell you why, though?
Why?
It's not for the PC answer you would be looking for.
Okay.
All right. So I'm looking at it like this. Serena been bad for a long fucking time, right?
Yeah.
Been sexy for a long time, right?
Yeah.
But she's been focused on her career.
Yep.
Sexy, bad. Every nigga love that ass, wanna fuck that ass. But the niggas that wanna fuck that ass ain't trying to settle down, right?
Hold your thought.
Uh-huh, go ahead.
For those dudes, the black dudes that's out here that's mad, remember she dated Common for a while.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, she's rumored to date Drake.
Right.
And then any other normal 9-to-5 dude that she might have dated during the time
she wasn't
that
she going was, for no broke nigga. I'm telling you that right now.
That's fine. Okay. Yeah. Right. Well, compared to her, the dude that she with right now is broke. But go ahead.
Yeah. I'm saying nigga. You didn't hear the last part.
Okay.
But at the same time, like I'm looking at, like I'm like Serena Williams is not out here. Like she had to understand her role as a sex figure out here.
Of course.
And she kept that up for the longest time, you know what I'm saying? Kept on playing tennis, kept on playing at a high capacity.
Yes.
However, like I said, I don't feel like she wanted to give herself to somebody that was just going to knock her up and get the fuck out of Dodge. She wanted to be sure that somebody was going to stay around. She didn't want to get with no niggas, bro. I'm tell you that right now.
Are you being racist right now, bro?
Yes, I am.
So you trying to say that black men have a tendency to knock women up and leave them?
Yes, I do.
Black men only? Or is it higher? Is it higher? A higher percentage of brothers out here knocking chicks up and leaving them? Is that what you're saying, killer?
I'm saying that's a higher percentage, yes.
And I'm saying fuck you for that shit, nigga.
However, I'm right.
I don't think you are, though, nigga. We gonna have to disagree on this shit, nigga.
That's cool.
Nah, son.
Yeah,
I think it's equal, man.
I
think it's equal. The same amount of that. Let's not talk about amount. Let's talk about percentages. The same percentage of deadbeat black fathers that's out here is the same percentage of deadbeat white fathers or Asian fathers
Here. I'm level of deadbeat though. I'm saying level of deadbeat. I'm saying like. There's bros out here that will fucking knock up a chick and have nothing to do with that child.
And I don't want to say that that's a black only thing. Or
I don't want to say
that that's a higher percentage. Like, yo, we gotta own that. Nah, son, fuck that.
I ain't trying to say this. We ain't owning that shit. I'm not trying to say that. But however, as far as my experience has been, we've been owning that. We've been taking that L.
we've been taking the L, but you got to remember, all of these L's that we've taken, where is this coming from? It's coming from the white media that want to portray.
Coming from the white media? Because I'm not, I don't feel like it's coming from the white media.
It's
I
coming
like
from the white media because personally, white, okay, white people.
Me personally, myself, I feel like it's coming from niggas that I affiliate myself with, niggas that I know.
You don't
personally
affiliate with no fuck niggas, man.
Nah,
that's fuck nigga shit.
I don't. And I really want the fucking world to know I don't affiliate with fuck niggas.
I know you don't.
All right.
So don't even pull that shit, nigga. All
right, sorry. Really, I'm sorry. But go ahead.
I feel like that narrative is coming from the yeah. When I say white media, man, yeah, white people run the country. White people run the world.
True.
They own all the TV stations, the CEOs, and all of that stuff.
Yeah.
So it's a narrative about black people that has to stay in the public eye to make us seem lower than we are. And that's where that comes from.
You think so?
It's a deeper way to dive into it, but we, you know what I'm saying, it's only an hour and a half
okay,
podcast.
So real, to do all that. So alright, so at the core of it all,
yeah,
we're not mad at Serena for getting with a white dude, right?
I'm not. Do your thing.
But at the same time, like, yeah, we're gonna feel some type of way that we the ones that knew how to appreciate what you have.
Obviously not.
What I'm saying though, my nigga,
settled down with one of us.
She ain't settled down with one of us. But we are the ones that said, oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Look at that ass.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Look at that thing poke out.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. She looks sexy in them shorts.
Mm-hmm.
We the ones that said that.
Oh,
they,
yeah.
They wasn't saying that.
No.
If y'all want to listen, you know what I'm saying? If y'all really want to know how white people feel about bitches with ass or females with ass, I'm sorry. I'm really working on saying that word, bitches, you know what I'm saying? I'm working on it. I'm getting past it.
Yeah, definitely.
But y'all, if y'all really want to know how white dude feel about ass, I seen a white dude at work and they're like, yeah, man, she's hot and look at that ass. And this bitch had the flattest ass I ever seen in my life.
Yeah.
They got a different perspective on what an ass
it's
is.
Alternative facts.
Yeah.
The ass that they be liking.
Yeah, the ass that be liking is like
that alternative ass.
Like, what?
They don't even be an onion, dude.
Yeah.
I don't know what to call that shit. They be like, dude.
I'll be like, what the fuck? All right,
should be
cool.
Square as hell.
So, that's what I'm saying. Like,
SpongeBob ass having ass.
That's what I'm saying. So, on the sexual, like, on the sex level scale, we brought.
Oh, yeah, we definitely sexualized Serena.
We
no
definitely
doubt.
Sexualized her more than anybody else
no
did.
Doubt. No
so
doubt.
So, we brought you up there.
Yeah. So, but I mean, like, personally.
Yeah.
I like Serena. I think she's a beautiful woman.
Because all that ass,
dog. Well, she's, but at the same time.
You trying to fuck all that muscle? No, you like all that ass.
Yes.
Yeah, okay,
she's a little too muscular for me.
Okay.
Like, I would like to see her after her playing days are done when she's just doing cardio instead of, like, actually working out. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, it is what it is with Serena, man. And you know, props to Serena for doing her thing. But yeah, I ain't mad at you. So we about to move on to the boy Kendrick Lamar. And for those that don't know, the boy Kendrick Lamar dropped the album Damn last week. We did like a little review on the Damn album. We definitely have a high ratings for it. We're gonna revisit it a little bit real quick, but just to kind of throw out some numbers out there, the boy Kendrick sold 610,000 equivalent album units.
Oh wow.
610,000. And they said about 60% of that is actual purchases. So I don't know if it's
so
a physical
copies?
I don't know if it's a physical copy out yet for the album. But what I'm saying is that 60% of that is actually people going on to iTunes or going on to Google Music or whatever and buying the album. 60% of that is that.
Oh wow.
The rest of it is like streaming and you know, however else they come up with the album units or whatever. So
that's wow, man.
Yeah, so at least what they say 60% of it, so at least what 350,000 of that or almost 400,000 is actual purchases.
Mhm.
So, you know what I mean? So salute to the boy Kendrick. As far as music goes, they say that hip hop is pretty much the only genre that's selling right now.
I believe that.
Before it used to be like country. Country on the sly used to be putting up numbers.
Integration, man.
Explain that.
What I'm saying is that there was a point in time that where, yeah, country and all that different music was popping, but now I feel like more white people, white kids, mm-hmm. are listening to hip hop.
Okay. So I agree with that.
If you want to be down with the shits, you had to listen to some hip hop. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like, yeah, that's what it is. That's what's causing all this to happen. Yeah. Hip hop is definitely the most outspoken, you know what I'm saying, genre of music.
Definitely. And I mean, I think we spoke about it before on here. I don't know if we specifically spoke about...
We kept it the realest.
Yeah, I don't know if we specifically spoke about the whole Drake versus Kendrick thing, but I remember talking to you about it, and I said to you, which I was wrong in looking at these numbers.
Yeah.
I said to you that it's no way that Kendrick is selling more records than Drake. And somehow, some way, this dude pulled off 610,000 copies in first week, or six album equivalent units, whatever. Well,
thank you for holding that, owning that, because I forgot about it.
I own that L, man. I hold that shit.
Yeah.
Hold that shit right.
Yeah, keeping it real. But that's what I was saying. Hip hop generation, hip hop people tend to keep it realer than any other genre of music. Mm-hmm. I feel. You know what I'm saying? We have our fuck boys out there that, you know what I'm saying, make dash music, but however we.
So with Kendrick though, I don't know if the right question is where did this come from, because you know he been doing his thing for quite some time now, but I think I said to you that the younger generation doesn't really appreciate lyricism. They don't appreciate the level of artistry of Kendrick Lamar. Okay.
And I'm gonna give you some credit.
Am I wrong for that? Or no, like you, who I know it's kind of hard to break down these demographics or whatever, but who actually is buying these copies?
Okay, so
under 30.
Before you become too hard on yourself for saying that, you've also said something about sonically.
Mm-hmm.
Some things have to work sonically.
Mm-hmm.
And you've said that before.
Mm-hmm.
And I think before I understood what Kendrick was talking about on this album, sonically, it really grabbed me.
Got you.
So before I even knew what he was saying, before I could even break down the lyrics, before I could even say, oh, this song is about this, or this song is about this, and this song conveys this kind of message.
Yes.
Sonically, I really felt it.
Okay, so the beats, everything outside
the cadence
of
that he goes on goes on his tracks with.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I was really able to gravitate towards that. And I think that he did a fantastic, if not damn near perfect job at producing a sonic album that people could hold. People were saying this was the best album less than 24 hours before it was released.
After
it was released.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's because of how it came across sonically.
And I mean, after sitting with the album for another week, I'm definitely growing to even appreciate it more than I said when we originally spoke about the album.
Yeah.
So it definitely it's not lacking. It's not dropping off or whatever. It's not falling to the back of my playlist or whatever.
Yeah. Nah, it's on the forefront of mind. Yeah,
this kind of brought up the whole Kendrick
that and Talib Kweli and
Styles P
7.
Yeah, that joint is dope too.
That joint's dope.
I mess with that heavy.
Yeah.
So this kind of brought people to start saying that Kendrick is like the best rapper of all time.
People are always gonna say something like that though.
Yeah,
I think that what's new and what's hot is always gonna be viewed as the best of all time. And it wasn't until I, you know what I'm saying, listened to like DJ Academics and Joe Buttons talk on their Everyday Struggle.
Yeah.
That I forgot who made the point, but you gotta look at who's listening to the music. Like, you and I are gonna view what the best of all time is differently from what the student generation views as the best of all time.
Yeah.
Because their best of all time started
at a
certain time.
Yeah.
So you and I can't say, well, you and I will never say that that's the best of all time.
No, hell no.
Hell no.
Hell no.
Hell but you know fuck
what?
No.
You know what? You know what? A lot of times that when people bring up Kendrick, right?
Yeah.
The first name that they kind of bring up Kendrick to discredit the argument that he's the greatest of all time or whatever is Scarface. I hear that a lot. Like listening to different podcasts and reading different articles and different radio interviews or whatever. Mm-hmm. A lot of people say, oh, you know, Kendrick, you know, his first 3-4 albums, whatever. Nobody has ever this, that, and the third, blah, blah, blah. Kendrick. And a lot of people like, yo, all right. He better than Scarface? Niggas be like, no. They be kind of dumbfounded, like.
But who though? Like niggas from our generation or niggas from like niggas in their 20s?
I don't think
niggas in their 20s know who the fuck Scarface is. I really can't believe that.
I think that they do. If you're a fan of hip hop, you know who Scarface is.
Yeah, but you don't know.
Yes, I agree, because. Yeah. The thing about Scarface is that he spanned different generations.
Yeah.
So he came out in the 80s.
I don't even think Scarface knows his
impact. Yeah.
I don't. I heard him in interviews. But the like, thing,
even like,
does
even
this nigga
like,
know how deep he goes?
Even like Lil Yachty the other day, a couple of months ago, said in an interview, he was like, yo, man, I ain't gotta be on a mic spitting a cold 16. Like, I ain't Scarface.
Oh, okay. That's it. Cool. That's what's up.
So obviously he know who Scarface is. Like, nigga, if I can get on the mic and I could turn up and I could say yeah, and that shit turnt, bro.
You do that shit perfect. I ain't gonna lie.
If that shit turnt, bro.
And I ain't gonna lie. I was really hating on Lil Yachty,
bro.
When I seen Lil Yachty on what was it, a Sprite commercial? What commercial did Lil Yachty have recently?
Call like Minnesota.
Yo, wow. This nigga's in a commercial with LeBron James.
Yo, hold on.
Fuck how wack you is. Nigga, you made it.
Exactly. Nigga, you made it. Listen.
Nigga, you made it.
Speaking of that shit, man, if y'all want to check out some hip hop, or I don't even want to call it hip hop, some music that you just want to laugh at, if you just want to get a laugh.
Yeah.
Google Ugly God.
Oh, that's my nigga. I fuck
Google
with
Ugly God and just listen to every song that you could find from Ugly God and just he don't take himself seriously. He don't take the music seriously.
Nah,
I'm not gonna lie, some of the songs is actually jamming.
They hitting, they hitting, they hitting.
But you, dude, you'll have the best time of your life. Just drink a cup, take a couple of shots, let it kick in,
let it ride,
and listen to some Ugly God and laugh your ass off.
I agree.
But back to Kendrick, man. Yeah, man. You know, a lot of people, you know, with this album, whatever, they kind of bringing him to the whole greatest of all time situation.
Yeah.
And I ain't even going to ask you, man. I know how you feel.
Yeah.
You know how I feel about the whole GOAT situation or whatever. But I guess, you know, then we come to the list. Is Kendrick Lamar is top what? Finish my sentence for me.
Fuck. Top fuck. He's okay. The hardest list to get into, I feel, is the top 10.
Mm-hmm.
And top 10 is gonna have, I feel like everybody's top 10. If you was a real hip hop fan, if you was a real nigga, your top 10 is gonna have 5 that's gonna always alternate with it, whether it's 1, 2, 3, or 4, or 5.
And we already know who this is.
We already know who those are. And then your other 5 is what's subject to what's new, what's hot, and what's dope.
Yeah.
At the time.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I feel like the top 5 is the list that counts. Top 10 is the list that the from 5 to 10 is the list that's gonna change.
Always.
Always.
Got you.
But 1 to 5.
So, I mean, for me to answer my own question.
Yeah.
Kendrick Lamar, to me,
uh-huh,
top 30.
That's real.
Not top.
I can't fuck with you.
Not top 20. When I say 30, I'm talking about somewhere between 20 and 30.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like if I sat down.
Right.
I could really name artists with careers.
Facts. Facts, Snapples.
Yeah.
Snapple facts.
Snapple caps.
Yeah, Snapple caps. Yo, Snapple caps.
For real.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't want to get into it. I don't want to sit here and be like, oh, this person is better than Kendrick. Kendrick ain't better than this person. Like, yo, I ain't trying to do all that. I'm just trying
to say. It's new to y'all. It's new to y'all. We get it. Yeah. It's new to this generation.
Like, you know what? We used to have this conversation when we was in high school all the time.
Yeah.
Yo. Tupac ain't better than Biggie. Biggie better than Tupac.
Yeah.
Tupac better than Biggie.
Yeah.
Snoop the best right now. This person the best right now.
Yeah.
I wonder who is, like, are they having that conversation right now?
They
in
are.
High schools in the United
they
States.
Are. They are. And but they're are, doing that based on what they know now. Like, but you know what I'm saying? I heard somebody the other day giving Kendrick Lamar props for being a storyteller. I'm like, have you ever heard Slick Rick tell a story?
Exactly.
Slick Rick is the
yes
best storyteller.
Yes.
Period.
Yes.
Period.
Yeah.
Fuck what you talking about,
Slick Rick. If you out there, nigga, you need to be writing in some fucking movies. You need to be doing something.
Yeah, my nigga.
Like, I don't understand why you not.
Why haven't you done this, Slick Rick? Like, why? You right. Slick Rick is the best.
You should be where Ice Cube is at right
That's
now.
That's what I'm trying. Yo, word.
Because Ice Cube was a great storyteller too, yeah, but I don't think he was a storyteller on the level of Slick Rick.
Not even close.
So, Slick Rick, you out there, man. You need to be doing your thing. You ever in Fort Lauderdale? Holla at your boys at Bootleg Hip Podcast.
I understand what this new generation is like. And I'm not trying to discredit y'all. I'm not like these other podcasts out here that shitting on this new generation. Mm-hmm. These millennials. Nah, I'm not doing that.
They got some dope cats out there, man.
Yeah, I got some dope people that's coming up in y'all generation.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I don't know how to accept or understand a lot of the music that's coming from these people.
Yeah.
But I fuck with y'all like sonically.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But like, don't put these people. Say when you say the best, I advise y'all, new generation motherfuckers, say the best in your generation. Because
unless you're willing to do the research.
You're willing to look and see the reactions
when certain songs came out. See the reactions of when Rakim Drock check out my melody.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, you're right. Unless you're willing to do the comparison, verse for verse, song for song.
Yeah.
If y'all can't do that, you know what I'm saying, and really fucking break down the contents and the relevance of these contents in the time that it came out.
Yeah.
You can't give them the best title.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Do your research, man.
Yeah, man. So what we had on time, man? It's
about time to push.
Yeah, we about time to push this shit, man.
Yeah. Yeah. But I mean, we had a good time with y'all, man. As usual, you know, I love coming here doing this podcast or whatever.
Definitely.
One of the things that I feel like before we go, or whatever, I feel like we never really gave a backstory on.
Yeah,
and I feel like I never gave a backstory on why I call myself P Double.
Okay,
right.
Good. Yeah.
So basically, just a quick backstory as far as the name where it comes from. When I was younger, when I was born, basically, my brother, he had a nickname of Pops, right? Mm. So my peoples used to call him Pops. My brother is 2 and some change years older than me.
Uh-huh.
And when I was born, he didn't know my name, so he started calling me Pops.
Mm.
That in turn had my people start to call me Pops and started him calling him by his name, right? So fast forward now when I got older and I started writing rhymes or whatever, I wanted to rap and this, that, and the third. And I put together my first project and whatever. And I always said to myself, I want to kind of, because it was a point in time where people thought Pops was like my real name.
Yeah.
In the streets. And when I say
Drew, shout out to the boy Drew, he calls you Pops.
Yeah. And when I say in the streets, I ain't no gangster nigga. I ain't no street nigga, no nothing like that. But you know what I'm saying? I used to play basketball. I used to go to different courts, whatever. Anybody who know me from the streets, know me from the basketball court, know me from after school or whatever, they all call me Pops, right?
Yeah.
So when I started rapping, I was like, man, Pops don't sound like a cool name to rap to. So I said that. I was looking at it.
3 into 4. My nigga P Double got this shit for y'all.
So I looked at it and I said, yo, I looked at my name and I was like, yo, they call me Pops or whatever. I got the name tattooed on my leg and everything.
Yeah.
I said it got 2 P's in it. And I was like, yo, I'm gonna call myself P Double. 2 P's. So that's where my name came from.
Okay.
P Double.
Dope. That's dope. And listen, my nigga.
So y'all hear me? It comes from somewhere. It's not like I just made it up out of nowhere. Like, y'all
so if we call really myself break, P Double. Yo, we break shit down. Like, yo, me and my nigga P Double, we became friends. Like, P Double started working the same job I worked at. I was there first, he came second.
Mm-hmm.
And like, yo, my man's passed me a fucking rap. A album,
mm-hmm.
a project that he worked on. And I listened to that shit, and I immediately, like, yo, I gravitated towards, you know what I'm saying, some of the stories that you was telling about your brother.
Yeah.
And I gravitated towards the real that you was putting out and the content that you was putting out.
Yeah.
And I really fuck with that. And you know what I'm saying, like, if you really got to talk to somebody that you was a fan of, like, what questions would you ask them?
Yeah.
And I had the luxury of asking somebody that I worked with, like, yo, holy shit, my nigga.
Yeah.
Yo, I fuck with this.
Yeah.
And that's how me and this nigga really got to fuck with each other. Like, yeah. I really fuck with this nigga based on his music. And I really got to know him based on his music before I even met this nigga. Before I really got to know this nigga. So, yo, you know what I'm saying? For all the aspiring artists, did I say that word right? Aspiring artists out there.
Yeah.
Just keep it real, man.
Yeah, definitely, man. Just keep it real. Be true to yourself.
Just be true to yourself. And that's what my dog P Double did. And that's what really gravitated me towards him, and that's really made me fuck with him, like, you know what I'm saying, his music.
Yeah, appreciate it.
I knew
it,
his music before I knew this man as a person.
True.
So, you know what I'm saying, that's crazy to say, but I really knew this man, his new music, before I knew him as a person.
For sure.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, with that being said, man, like I said, once again, like I said earlier, follow us on all social media.
Yeah, yeah,
for those that made it to the end, as we always say. Yeah. Instagram, Twitter,
yeah.
Facebook, like our Facebook page.
Yeah.
Follow us on the YouTube.
Yeah.
For those that don't know, we also have the SoundCloud. So we got YouTube and SoundCloud.
And subscribe. Just hit that subscribe button. Look down. Yeah. You see that subscribe button right there? Press it.
Press it.
We're getting better. We got an interview coming up with an aspiring artist, you know what I'm saying, by the name of Ro. We're going to put that out for y'all.
Yeah.
We're going to keep showing y'all love. Talk shit to us.
Definitely.
Tell us the real. We only trying to get better for you.
Yes, all right, sir.
Bootleg Cable Podcast.
You can't spell that.
Something wrong with your ass. Shit, yes, bootleg.
But it ain't nothing fake about it.
We here.
Yeah.